Very good morning, dear students. Today we will continue the chapter The Sound of Music, Part 2, The Shehnai of Bismillah Khan. In our previous video, we have discussed about the Shehnai and how the Pungi was converted into Shehnai, I told you earlier. As the story goes on, since it was first played in Shah chamber and was played by a Nai. Nai means barber. So that the instrument was named the Shehnai. And I discussed with you that the credit for bringing this instrument onto the classical stage goes to Ustad Bismillah Khan. Now here, as you can see here on the main screen, that here is a description of Ustad Bismillah Khan. Ustad Bismillah Khan, who was considered a renowned Shehnai player, he had no peer, no companion as a Shehnai player. Okay, now we will discuss some points about his family and him. Now look at here, Ustad Bismillah Khan belonged to Banaras Gharana. First of all, as I discussed with you, that he belonged to a family of Shehnai players. He was very hard working. He was a very dedicated soul. He devoted himself to have mastery over Shehnai. Okay, because As I told you earlier, that the credit for upbringing, okay, so onto the classical stage goes to Ustad Bismillah Khan. Now look at here, who is Ustad Bismillah Khan? Ustad Bismillah Khan, he belonged to the Banaras Gharana, okay? He lived there in Banaras. He was born in 1916 at Dumro in Bihar. As a 5-year-old boy, Bismillah Khan played gilli danda near a pond. Okay, because he was a very short boy, so during his childhood time, he would play gilli danda near a pond. He used to visit Bihariji temple. Okay, he would regularly go to the nearby Bihariji temple to sing the Bhojpuri chaita. Okay, look at here, he used to visit Bihariji temple and sing Bhojpuri chaita there. Okay, Bhojpuri mein alag alag tarah ke jo raag aur ye chait gaye jate hain, wo bhi wahan par gaya karte the. And after this, means after singing there at the Bhojpuri, after singing Bhojpuri chaita there in Bihariji temple, he would earn a big laddu. Okay, and he would earn a big laddu from a local Maharaja as a prize. Here, the main screen is describing about the family background of Ustad Bismillah Khan. Okay, I am going to repeat the same points once again. Ustad Bismillah Khan, who belonged to the Banaras Gharana, he was born in 1916 at Dumro in Bihar. As a 5-year-old boy, he also played gilli danda like everyone plays, means every, like the normal child, okay, he would play gilli danda near a pond. He used to visit Bihariji temple. At Bihariji temple, he would sing Bhojpuri chaita, and at the end of which, he would earn a big laddu from a local Maharaja as a prize. Okay, and when it happened? It happened, you can imagine now, means how much time has been spent. So the boy has got so many award also, okay, for upbringing Shehnai onto the classical stage. He had got so many awards also, and he had earned the highest civilian award in India, the Bharat Ratna. You all of have heard the name. Okay, so this Ratna, Bharat Ratna, was given to Ustad Bismillah Khan for his upbringing to Shehnai. Clear? Now move towards the next. At the age of 6, he moved to Banaras. Okay, at the age of 6, he moved to Banaras where his uncle lived. Okay, he was born on 21st March 1916. Bismillah Khan, he belonged to a well-known family of musicians. His grandfather's name was Rasool Bakhsh Khan. He was also a Shehnai Nawaz of the Bhojpur King's court. Okay, his father's name was Pagambar Bakhsh. And he was, and other paternal ancestors were also great Shehnai players. Now, look at here. At the age of 6, what happened? He moved to Banaras. When he moved to Banaras, who was living there? His uncle Ali Baksh. Ali Baksh introduced him to the nuisances of playing Shehnai. Okay, nuisances means he started playing the new instrument Shehnai. उन्होंने ही अली बख्स ने ही उन्हें नई इस शहनाई को क्या करवाया सबसे पहले बजाने के लिए इंट्रोड्यूस करवाया. ही वॉज डीपली डिवोटेड टू म्यूजिक. उनके जो अंकल थे वो भी क्या थे, ही वुड ऑल्सो प्ले शहनाई. एंड बिस्मिल्ला खान वो क्या किया करते थे, ही ऑल्सो सिट कैप्टिवेटेड फॉर आवर्स ऑन एंड. काफ़ी टाइम उन्हीं के साथ वहाँ पर स्पेंड किया करते. He used to spend most of his time practicing on the bank of the river Ganga. Okay, and at the end of the chapter, you will find out that how much Bismillah Khan loved Ganga. Okay, because he did not want to leave Hindustan. He used to spend most of his time practicing on the bank of the river Ganga. And that's why the themes of his music are deeply affected by the flowing water of the Ganga. Means mainly जो भी उन्होंने अपनी music में add किया वो music का theme mainly किससे belong करता था, flowing water of Ganga. Clear? Now I am going to repeat all the points once again. Bismillah Khan, who was born on 21st March 1916, belonged to a well-known family of musicians from Bihar. His father पैगंबर बख्श. ओके, ही वॉज ऑल्सो अ शहनाई प्लेयर. एंड नाउ लुक एट हेयर, एट द एज ऑफ 6 ही मूव्ड टू बनारस. ओके, बनारस में कौन थे, उसके मामा जी. ओके, मैटर्नल अंकल हाउस था वहाँ पर, और वहाँ से उन्होंने क्या स्टार्ट किया, ही स्टार्टेड डिवोशन टू म्यूजिक. एंड ही यूज टू स्पेंड most of his time practicing on the bank of river Ganga, and that's why the themes which he took for his music are deeply affected by the flowing water of Ganga. Clear? Now move towards the next part. Look at here, he got the best performer award. As I described you earlier that he got the highest civilian award in India. And which is the highest civilian award in India? The Bharat Ratna. He got many awards. So, first of all, look at here. He got the best performer award at the All India Music Conference in Allahabad in 1930. Okay? In 1930, he got the best performer award. In 1937, he bagged 3 medals at a music conference in Calcutta. Okay, and with the opening of All India Radio in Lucknow in 1938, I am going to remind all the points one by one. First of all, look at here. In 1913, he got the Best Performer Award at All India Music Conference in Allahabad. In 1937, he bagged 3 medals at a music conference in Calcutta. And the next I am going to repeat, here it is not given, that with the opening of All India Radio in Lucknow in 1913, that proved Bismillah Khan's big break. वहाँ से उन्हें सबसे ज़्यादा बड़ा big break मिला. And he soon became an often heard. Often heard means ज़्यादातर सुनने वाले शहनाई player वो बन गए. और कहाँ पर बने? On radio. Okay? After 1913, the most important event, and what was the important event? When India gained independence on 15th August 1947, Bismillah Khan became the first Indian to greet the nation with his shehnai. उन्होंने पहली बार, बिस्मिल्ला खान ने जब 15th अगस्त 1947 का हमारा इंडिपेंडेंस हमें मिला, तब बिस्मिल्ला खान फर्स्ट इंडियन बन गए टू ग्रीट द नेशन. उन्होंने वहाँ पर उन्हें चांस मिला, एक अपॉर्चुनिटी मिली शहनाई प्ले करने के लिए, और वहाँ पर उन्होंने कौन सा राग गाया, राग काफ़ी, ठीक है। और वहाँ पर जितनी भी ऑडियंस थी उन सभी ऑडियंस को क्या किया, इन्होंने ग्रीट किया। और ऑडियंस में मेनली कौन कौन थे, विच इंक्लूडेड द ग्रेट पर्सनैलिटीज लाइक महात्मा गांधी, पंडित जवाहरलाल नेहरू, ओके, ऑल द फेमस पर्सनैलिटीज वर देयर। नाउ मूव टुवर्ड्स द नेक्स्ट वन, ही वॉज इन्वाइटेड बाई पंडित नेहरू टू प्ले द शहनाई फ्रॉम द रैम्पेट्स ऑफ डेलीज रेड फोर्ट इन 1947। As I described you earlier, that when India gained independence on 15th August 1947, Bismillah Khan became the first Indian to play the Shehnai there. Because it was an auspicious occasion, you can say, because all the famous personality were there. And it was a big day for all us, for all Indians. He won many international awards as well. ओके, लाइक भारत रत्न एंड ऑल द म्यूजिकल कॉन्फ्रेंस, एट ऑल द म्यूजिकल कॉन्फ्रेंस ही गोट मैनी अवार्ड्स, ही गोट इंटरनेशनल अवार्ड्स एज वेल। ही लव्ड बनारस एंड डुमरो वेरी मच। ही डिक्लाइंड एन ऑफर फ्रॉम वन ऑफ हिज स्टूडेंट्स। एक्चुअली व्हाट हैपेंड वन डे, उनके एक स्टूडेंट ने उन्हें क्या ऑफर किया, टू सेटल इन द यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स ऑफ अमेरिका, वहाँ पर एक अपना म्यूजिक स्कूल बनाने के लिए ऑफर किया, ओके, एंड एट दैट टाइम ही डिक्लाइंड द सेम ऑफर। उन्होंने इस ऑफर को क्या कर दिया, मना कर दिया। क्यों मना कर दिया, बिकॉज ही लव्ड बनारस एंड डुमरो वेरी मच। This is it with today. We will continue the same in next video. Thank you.